So in this video, we will cover boosting and gradient boosted trees. So in order to understand gradient boosted trees, we need to understand boosting first. Boosting is also known as stage-wise additive modeling. So the idea is, in contrast to random forest, where all the decision trees are trained in parallel, in boosting, only one model after the other is trained based on outputs from previous models. Again, this is an ensemble of weak models. So let's consider hi of x to be a weak model. So I is an index of the model. So then we can define a strong learner capital F of x as the sum of all the weak models weighted by gamma I. This is another notation which is maybe a bit more intuitive. So if you want to define the model capital Fm of x, it is equal to capital Fm minus 1 of x plus gamma m times hm of x, where Fm minus 1 of x is the previous model and gamma m times hm of x is the weighted current model. So gamma m is a learned weight, and don't be scared, it looks a bit complicated, but it's relatively easy to understand how we derive gamma m. So we are taking the argmin. If you never have seen that notation, argmin means that we are optimizing or minimizing, in this case, a function with respect to gamma in this case. And then we have to understand what L means. So L basically is the sum of squared errors. So that's a measure how good or how bad we are doing. We call this also residuals. So we take the correct value of yn and we subtract the predicted value, we square it, and we add it up for all the training examples, and we normalize it. We will later see why we have 1 over 2 of n and not 1 over n. That's just because taking the derivative is more simple then. So let's actually take the derivative of that function. So we take the partial derivative with respect to wj, and it looks like this. So let's have a look at each individual component. The reason why we just can pull out the whole term from the sum is because of the rule that the partial derivative of a sum is just the sum of the partial derivatives. And then we pull the squared to the front, and that's because of the rule that the derivative of x to the power of n equals to n times x to the power of n minus 1. And the last thing we have to understand is why we put this x and j here. So x and j is basically a term which is part of the weak learner. And since we are taking the partial derivative of L with respect to wj, the chain rule says that we need to pull out x and j, since wj is part of a nested multiplicative term, whereas all the other wj's become constants and cancel out. So those are the rules which we are using here. The second rule is called the chain rule for partial differentiation. So now we have learned what L is. We take the sum over all the training examples, and since L is the first derivative of the sum of squared errors, we have yi, which is the real value, and the prediction of y hat based on x, and that's the term where we minimize over to obtain an optimal value for gamma m. So now let's have a look how gradient boosted trees are working. So let's consider our training data set. So we start with a weak learner, h0, and we just take the mean of y as a prediction. Of course, this is not a very good model. Therefore, we have an error term. So error 1 equals to y minus f0 of x. The output is basically a new training data set. Those are called residuals. It's basically the error of the previous model. So now we define a new model f1 of x based on f0 of x plus a new weak learner h1, which we train on the residuals. And we will continue this step. So we compute the error of the newly obtained model, epsilon 2 equals y minus f1 of x. And again, that we are using to train a weak learner, H2. And we just continue until we are converging. So gradient boosted trees are outperforming random forest, but they are computationally more expensive because of their sequential nature. Remember, in random forest, you can in theory train all the decision trees on the samples which you have obtained by bootstrapping. But here, each iteration is dependent of the residuals of the previous iteration. Therefore, it's hard to parallelize. But there is hope. There is a specific implementation which is called XGBoost, which is very fast, and it has a slightly different implementation which makes it even more resistant to overfitting. So in summary, boosting is different from bootstrapping because we are taking the error into account which we are doing during building up the model. Especially, we will create decision trees which are specifically dedicated to training data where our previous model is doing a bad job, and the weight how strongly this weak learner per iteration is added to the model is learned with an additional weight gamma m.